Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone. We are from C23PR 590 team, and today we will present about our capstone project. It names Rikomenu. So here's our team members.
There's me, Halus Gananta from Machine Learning Path.
My name is Rizky Soerlan from Machine Learning Path.
Next, my name is Bagas Yusahyo from Machine Learning Path 2.
My name is Daniel Leonardo from Cloud Computing Learning Path.
My name is Ermat Chanwar Rahman from Cloud Computing Learning Path.
And my name is Mohamed Faris Haidar from Mobile Development Learning Path. So here's our list of content. There are project background and then reason, and the third is existing result, and then implementation, and for the last is our business model canvas.
Alright, we go to the first list is project background. We have two facts that we made. So the first one is based on BPS data for 2020, MSMEs in Indonesia are dominated by the culinary by a total of 1.51 million units. And the second one, the fact is Kantar Brave's survey between 4,190 consumers in September 2020 to March 2021 for avoiding lines at places to eat. Okay, we go to the second list of content. Why? The reason why. The first one is operational efficiency. We know the reduces of reliance of wait staff or cashiers, allow for shorter queues, and it is also optimizes the ordering process. And the second thing, enhance customer experience, provide flexibility for customers to explore the menu independently, view pictures, descriptions, and prices of items in more detail. And the third thing is operational efficiency, integrated payment features allowing customers to pay for their orders directly through the app.
Chart is existing result. There are some few of our recommended application, but in here we only provide three of some UI. There are sign-in, and then recommendation, and checkout feature. In sign-in, user can enter username, also password for authentication. After sign-in, user move to recommendation, which will recommend user for some menu based on feature, based on favorite ingredients and spice level. And then after user visit who wants to buy, they move to checkout menu, which contain purchase summary.
This is implementation of machine learning for face recognition. For dataset, we use pre-existing dataset on Kaggle and PGDFS model to train the dataset. The dataset contain 30 class of face image. The input of the model we use 224, and for the API we use SFE API. When we input the image, the result of the output is the JSON file which contain the class and the confidence.
Next is the implementation for the recommender system. Our recommender system was built using a dataset that consists of a customer characteristic, which contains the data about what the customer would like to have in their orders, such as pepperoni or chicken or beef and so on. And then there is also the food characteristics CSV, which includes the ingredients such as the pepperoni, chicken, beef, vegetable, mushroom, and so on. And lastly, the order history of the customers, which indicate which customer have purchased a menu before. And then the architecture. The architecture for the recommender system uses a content-based filtering. In a content-based filtering, the recommendation is based upon the characteristic of each user and also the characteristic of each food. For building this content-based filtering, we use a two-tower network architecture, where as seen on the picture, there's something that is like two tower with one top there. So the each of the tower there so was supposed to do an embedding on each of the user features and also the item features. After that, they will be doing a product, which then outputs a score of whether the customer would like to buy or not to menu. And then we use binary cross entropy and achieve a performance of 0.1411 for the loss and 0.2 for the validation loss. Next.
Next is cloud computing implementation. We built a backend for the app, and for the REST API, we create using Express.js, and we deploy the REST API using App Engine. And for the machine learning API, we deploy using Cloud Run, and for the data, we choose MongoDB for the database, for the store database.
So here's the implementation from mobile development. There are Figma for the user interface or UX design. In Figma, we create the user interface like a padding, margin, and design system. And then the IDE, we use Android Studio and of course Kotlin programming language. And the library we use for the application is Retrofit 2. So here's about our business model canvas. First about key partners, it's like UMKM restaurant and cafes, and of course visual content creator. And then the key activities is like application development includes design, coding, testing, and iteration to produce a functional and responsive. And then integration with restaurant and cafes system, it's like linking the recommended application with restaurant and cafe system to obtain accurate menu information and manage the ordering process. And last one is user data collection. It's for collect user data such as food, ordering preferences, order history, and reviews to support the system recommendation feature.
For value proposition, this is easy and fast access. And for description, for food information, then personal recommendation, good. For customer relationship, we have promo, discount, and feedback from customer. And then the channel, we use social media, Google Play Store, and user-friendly interface.
And next, cost structure. It is data collection, infrastructure, prototyping, development, marketing, and team salary. And then revenue stream, it is premium model, affiliate marketing, and advertising revenue.
And that's all for our team. And thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.